Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Nelson Photo. This week we are doing another unboxing of the S1H. So this camera has a 24.2 megapixel full frame sensor, and in video will shoot 6K at 24 frames per second in a 3:2 aspect ratio, or will shoot 5.9K at 30 frames per second in a 16:9 aspect ratio. And it will also shoot at full 422 10-bit Glory in 4K and Cinema 4K at 60 frames per second in Super 35. And if that's not enough, it will also shoot 422 10-bit 4K at 30 frames per second over the full image area. So this camera has 14 stops of dynamic range with V-Log and V-Gamut Log modes pre-installed for your convenience, and also shoots in anamorphic 4:3 modes for those cinematic lens flares. So the new sensor is a dual native ISO sensor and has a threshold of 640 at the low and 4000 at the high, in comparison to Panasonic's own low light beast, the GH5S, which is what I'm filming on now. It has a low of 400 and a high of 2500 respectively. So if you're not familiar with the dual native ISO, basically what it will do is it will allow you to shift from low sensitivity light to high sensitivity light without producing that high grain noise in which you'll get if you're shooting in a high ISO in general. Bottom line, the dual native ISO allows you to shoot and produce much, much less noise. It is also the first mirrorless camera to have a fan in it. The fan will slow down when you're recording so you don't hear much noise, and it will turn on when you stop recording. So even though this camera is made for videos, it will shoot stills in 14-bit RAW, and it has a high resolution mode where you can shoot 8 images that will form into a 96 megapixel image. We have a lot of paperwork. Mainly it ends up being the manual, which we don't love. So in our next box, we have our goodies of your strap so you can rep your brand. It also definitely has to have the S1H on there so you know that you are carrying a beast. Ah, da, da, da. All right, there we have it. Look at this, look at this. This is like 4 inches wide or something. I don't know, it's huge. It is a true beast. This is definitely made for video. You can tell the minute you look at it. Look at that, that's where that fan is. That's lifting up your LCD screen by a good solid, I don't know, like half an inch or something. That's really intense. So here we go, let's take another look around. We have your fully articulating screen. And then over here, like I showed you, this is where your fan is. So you have one side over here to release the air, and then another side over here. And on the back, you have your really nice dial over here, your lock, your view, your toggle button over here. Sorry, I'm trying to show you guys backwards and it's not working out that well. And then on the top here, you have 3 customizable settings. You have your standard white balance, ISO, exposure compensation, your nice red button, your nice red lineage over here. On the back, you have your toggle over here, your dial over here, and then you have a cue in there, which is for quick mode to your menu. And yeah. Thanks guys for joining in. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click that bell icon down below so you can get notifications on our next video.